Hey. Woo. Candid, clean in conversations. Everybody gather round, it's a celebration. That we're still standing. Big up Katrina, she the inspiration. Came up from the bottom, she here with that motivation. Here to teach and inspire. Help you aim higher, help you dream bigger. Get what you desire. Real recognize, real iron sharp as iron. Let us grow your cleaning business. She ain't playing around, yeah, the queen mean business. So stick around, get down with a podcast. Hold it down, here we go, foot on the gas. Candid, clean in conversation.
Hey. All right, everybody, welcome back to another episode of
Candid Cleaning Conversations.
How you doing? Today we have another very, very, very special guest. All right, let me read my little thing. He was a managing director of A&A Solutions, franchisee consultant for JanPro, school foundational board member of Portsmouth, Virginia. He's a husband. He's a father. You may know him as the owner of Clean Biz Network. Please give a round of applause for Mr. AJ Simmons.
What up? I'm clapping for myself.
All right, man. I finally got you in Savannah. Got you inside the studio. First of all, I want to thank you because my audience knows like what you've done for me in my career. You know, I always tell the story to my students on how, you know, when I first started the whole coaching thing and trying to do my YouTube page, I really didn't know what to do or how to do this whole thing. So I was going in Facebook groups. Yeah. And I was just kind of like dropping the video and stuff like that. And then I was getting banned from everybody's stuff. It was like, But you were actually the first person to embrace what I was doing. You was like, well, shit, I share it for you. Like, boom. And I thought that was different. Yeah. I was like, well, dang, you didn't ban me. You didn't spam me. Okay,
right.
So this is cool or whatever. So I wanted to thank you for your humbleness and you just really embracing another person that's coming up doing the same thing that you was doing. You were coaching people. And I just knew that you were just authentic with your message. And a lot of what you do is within me now. So I just wanted to say I thank you for that.
Thank you. Thank you for that.
So for the people that don't know, who is AJ Simmons?
I'm everything you just said in that intro. So entrepreneur first, right? I'm entrepreneur, founder of Clean Biz Network. I'm a family guy. So a husband, father, all of that. I mean, I'm just a mentor to many people around the world, and I just do my best to try to help people increase my net worth at the same time.
All right. So now let's talk about Clean Biz Network, because he be trying to be light with who
I
he
know,
is.
Right?
But,
right,
you know, he's a giant in the game, y'all. But we let's talk about Clean Biz Network and how did it all come about? Like, I know that you first started off with a cleaning company.
Yeah.
Right. So how did you make the transition from having a cleaning company to Clean Biz Network? And most importantly, tell them what it is. What is Clean Biz Network?
So I guess we'll start with that before I forget it. So Clean Biz Network is basically, it started off as a coaching group.
Right. Okay.
And then we evolved more into more of a software company today. So you got a CRM, it's a bidding calculator, proposal generator, lead generation service. Like I said, CRM. And then also we still have the coaching element there as well. So it's just basically, we try to do our best to be everything that somebody would want to have if they were starting, growing, or trying to scale their cleaning company.
Right.
So in a nutshell, that's Clean Biz Network. And how I got there was, I was a franchise owner for Coverall. Screwed that up. I had to get out of that. Right. I was a franchise owner for JanPro. Mm-hmm. That actually went well. I won Franchise Owner of the Year, honorable mention. And then they hired me to be the operations manager for them. And once I became an employee for them, I realized, okay, their values and my values ain't quite the same.
Right.
And so I said, you know what, I'm just going to leave this job. So I left the job. I quit the job, sold my cleaning company, A&A Solutions, to my brother when he came home from prison.
Right.
And then I had to start over fresh. So I just straight up started Clean Biz Network. I didn't have no bunch of cash reserves in the bank. I ain't had no job. I left the job from JanPro.
Right.
Went all in on Clean Biz Network.
Right.
That lead generation in particular, you know what I mean, is what really made it work. And then we just went up from there.
So you basically, you found all the pains in your cleaning company and really you were like, listen, I'm going to solve each and every pain that a cleaning business owner has.
Right.
So by you being working within your company, you were able to like really know what we need.
Exactly.
You know what I mean?
Exactly.
Like, and I think it was a benefit for you that you actually worked for the franchise company.
Oh, that was the biggest benefit. Like, I know they probably hang themselves or point, like kick themselves yes. every day for letting me get on the inside of that, because I ain't gonna lie, that's when I really learned. Because I mean, at the peak of my cleaning company, I probably had maybe like 25 or some accounts, my max on the commercial side. So it was like, well, when I got to working for them, then I'm managing hundreds of contracts at once, and I'm the operation man. I got to go inspect every single one. So I got to see you any type of contract pretty much in the commercial space. I'd have been through it, and I had to coach these unit franchise owners how to handle these situations, because I had already did it on my side of things, but just not at that scale. And so that experience definitely was the biggest game changer for sure.
Man, because people always be asking us questions. Should I get a franchise? Should I just be sending them to you. Okay, you might as well just go to agent.
Right.
Like nowadays, like, you know what I mean? Like, because everything that he offers, like people know that with the franchises, they take all these fees and it's just
everything.
It's not fair sometimes, man. And it's different when a person comes in that actually has a heart and understands that you know, something ain't right with this. We really want to help people out, man, because this didn't help me when I was doing this. I couldn't get rich doing this. You know what I'm saying? So I looked at it like that. I was like, man, that was a blessing in disguise.
Right.
That was a blessing in disguise for you.
It was, you know? And I didn't even know it. You know what I mean?
I know. It's like that sometimes, you know? It's definitely like that.
And you
I'm
know what?
You ask the next
I just want to say that real quick. Shout out to Justin Kiley, though. He was the guy who hired me from Jam Pro.
Okay.
He was the master franchise owner for Jam Pro of Jacksonville, Orlando, and somewhere else in Florida. But anyway, but I remember when he first hired me and I wanted to quit. And he didn't want me to quit yet because I was good at the job.
Right.
And so he was like, well, I would imagine that for what you're trying to do, because he saw what I already had, like my starter kit and stuff online. So he was like, well, I would imagine that for what you're trying to do, this going to help you anyway.
Mm-hmm.
And so I really got to give him his credit. Like, first, he definitely like saved me just by giving me the job. You know what I mean? And then also by like giving me that nugget to let me know, like, you're right, I am gonna need this experience later
on.
And it paid off, so shout out to him.
Exactly. Yeah, that was some free experience right there. I mean, you know what I mean? You worked for the company, you learned what you learned, and then it took you somewhere else.
Sure.
That's no different from when I first met Tamika. She was thinking she wanted to be a tattoo artist.
Right.
And all this other different stuff. Mm-hmm. But when she came in on here, she made a transition onto doing what she does now.
Yes.
You know, she's into everything now. She wants to do digital stuff. She want to do CRMs, be a saleswoman, you know. So she's definitely in a different place, and that falls back to the people that you're around and community.
Absolutely. Mm-hmm.
Okay, and this is why we say that y'all need to be to the conference on June 29th and the 30th.
Yes.
Okay, and get around some like-minded people, because like community and networking is huge.
Yep.
By you being in that environment, it changed your life.
Yeah.
Okay. It's like people don't understand that when you're in the right environments, you can look up and rub shoulders with the right person that will change your life.
Fact.
You're right. And you speaking about changing lives, like I must say, between AJ and Ms. Johnson, like you guys are definitely transformational. You guys are not transactional. You are definitely transformational. You guys have changed a lot of people's lives because your expertise, y'all could have kept that sauce to y'allself. Right. You know what I'm saying? But y'all shared the love, and that was enough inspiration for me.
Right.
You know what I mean? And I really appreciate that, because a lot of people feel like, dang, now I can do this. Because you know how it is when you up and people be like, well, I don't know if I can really make this work or something like that, because I got bills, I got kids. But just to see the transparency from both of y'all, it's like, you don't care. All right, I got bad kids, but you gonna see them. You know what I'm saying? I got a little puppy, but you gonna see them.
Right.
You know what I'm saying? So I really appreciate that, because a lot of people aren't transparent. They are more so just give me your money, but y'all are not about that. Of course you want to charge for your experience and for your information, but you guys, It's like, I really appreciate y'all,
if
man.
If they buy the ticket from me, they buy it. If they buy it from him, they buy it. Right. I don't really care. We make the bulk of our money from Tenacity Clean over there. Right. Okay. So, you know, it's all about giving back. And it feels good when people come up to you and be like, you know what? You changed my life. Just the same way I told him, humbly. Yes. Yeah. Like, you really changed my world, mm-hmm. and everything that I have going on, man. Mm-hmm. That I give it up to him. Right. So, it's all about being in the right. So, let's take a deep dive.
Okay. I want to know, what keeps you motivated, Aiden? Like, for real, because I done heard you say a couple of times, you be like, yeah. man, I want to quit this shit. Like,
yeah, for real, though.
Like. So, like, what keeps you motivated and be like, you know what, I'm going to give it another shot?
Now, piggybacking pretty much what you just said, mm-hmm. the amount of people, lives, that, like, people coming to me nonstop telling me how I changed their life, right. that's the number one thing, is the world, basically. And then, obviously, my family. And then, for me, just personal. I ain't trying to get no job.
You like me.
I'm not trying to go back to no job. So mm-hmm. Them three things alone is pretty much it. And then just the fact now I kind of grew into a position where, like, even for extended family, I'm the guy now financially. So it's like, I don't never want to be in a position to where it's like, AJ, I'm about to, I mean, get put out my crib. Can you please spot me this? And I not have it. You know what I mean? Like, if I decide not to give it to you for whatever other reason, and that's my decision, but I don't never want it, the reason to be, I ain't got it. So, like, all of those things combined is what really keep me going.
I love it.
So, have you ever had, like, a hard time when you felt like giving up and giving everything up? Just throwing in the towel, just like, you know what? I don't want to do this. I'm going to figure something else out. Real estate, something.
At mm-hmm. least once a month. At least. I mean, like, I think the number one thing these days is the complaints. Like, because you know, with the lead generation in particular, yeah. you've been down this road, and it's like... People are complaining. Like, dog, I told you how this go. When you go to the appointment, if they let you do a walkthrough, then you good. Sell them, close the deal. And right. then it's like, if they don't let you do the walkthrough, let us know. We'll replace it. If you don't want a replacement, right. we'll give you your money back.
Right.
You don't have to do all of this, you know what I mean, complaining and pretending like we scamming you when we not. You know what I mean?
They be quick to say that.
Just follow the protocol. It's very, very simple. Right. Don't come on my Instagram and shit. All in my comments trying to do all this and that when we have a whole customer service team there for you. You know what mm-hmm. I mean? So just those things alone just made me be like sometimes, because I don't like ungratefulness. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
And so it's like, man, you know what? Actually, I keep all the leads for myself. You know what I mean? I got it from here on out. Don't even worry.
He is so much like
that. Oh my God. It's creepy.
Because I be like that too. I be like, no. Because see, I'm trying and I'm giving you all the stuff, and you want to sit there. Okay, guess what? And she be the one like, now,
right.
listen, let's level head. Come on, let's think. You can't let your emotions run your business.
Exactly. Right.
You can't let the 8-year-old version of Katrina Johnson run your That's company. Right. Okay, so you have to think level headed. Woosah, because you're on to something.
Yeah.
And I didn't want you to ever give that up. Right. You are on to something. And I want to say that you have improved the lead generation.
Oh, for sure.
It has improved like 10x.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? We buy leads from you all the time.
Yeah, I think y'all my biggest customer now, honestly.
We buy leads all the time.
Because I keep seeing it come. Because my wife, like, she used to enter them. She don't enter them no more, but she still mm-hmm. get the emails when they come through.
Right, mm-hmm. right.
And she was like, Mr. Johnson back again. Miss Katrina going in. I said, okay.
We about to keep on, because the way they coming, they come in pretty fast. And listen, money loves speed.
It do.
So whatever you did to make the leads come in quicker, you need to keep doing that.
Sure.
That's great.
They coming in really, really fast.
Good. And they're not bad leads. Right. We actually won one of them leads, I'll tell you.
Okay.
I'll tell you what. We did win one of the leads. He didn't pay us on time. But they don't got nothing to
do with
you.
Right, they got nothing to do with us. They got nothing to do with us, though.
They don't got nothing to do with you. Okay, but we did win one of the leads that you had sent in. And then some of the leads, we give leads away all the time in our community.
That's what's
right. So for our people, we run challenges on our community. And that's one thing that we do at the end of the mm-hmm. month. I used to give them away every week. I'd be like, listen, I give you a lead if you go through this channel.
Right. Mm-hmm.
You know, so that's another
crazy
thing. That
I ain't even, because I do that, like, if it's slow down and we ain't got no customers, I'll just tell Bill and them, I'm like, hey, just send me the lead. Mm-hmm. And I just find random people to get them to
and
locally.
Just give them some leads. And another thing. The leads are not expensive.
Oh my God,
people
they're
think
not.
They are. I don't know
they're
why.
They're not expensive, but I feel like they don't understand. Just like with this whole conference and tickets being $200.
Yeah.
I've been talking about that too.
Okay. I mean, the tickets being $200. I go on EYL and I go on when don't let Stormy do an event. Don't let Annetta do an event.
Okay. Don't let Eric Thomas do an event.
These people are charging $5,000. I done seen a $10,000 ticket, y'all. Mm-hmm. A $10,000 ticket. So I told Tamika we need to do a whole episode on mindset.
Yeah.
You know, it's mainly mindset. The people that feel like, because see, I said, I know it's all mindset because I come from the club era where you pay $5 to get inside the club. Mm-hmm. Where you pay $10 to get inside the club. Mm-hmm. Okay, so when you go from $5 and $10 to $100 and $200, right. It may sound like it's a lot of money. Right. It may sound like, damn, why are you charging all that much? Just to give somebody information or just to, you know what I mean? But they don't really understand the value it is in being there with other multimillionaires that are doing way more better than you. You could just sit there and you can, y'all calling me for coaching calls, y'all need to be talking to them, okay?
Hello.
I'm going to be there talking to some of them. Whoever's talking. Listen, I got some questions. Mm-hmm. I already know who I'm going to be talking to.
Jason Lee. Look.
Okay.
Jason Lee.
Come here. Oh, man. Right.
I got some questions.
And look, he's an open book, too. I'm telling you right now.
Okay. All the
problems.
Sauce.
Listen, think about all the problems that we deal with in our cleaning company.
Yeah.
Every day. That is the time when you can rub shoulders with someone that's past all them problems. Mm-hmm. And they can tell you, hey, well, all you got to do is, and a lot of times, this is another thing that kills me. The cliche stuff works.
Yeah.
It really be all the simple stuff. A lot of times be the stuff we already know.
Right.
You know you got to stay consistent. Mm-hmm.
Right.
Yeah. You know you may need to run some ads.
Right. The basics. You know what I mean?
It be the basic stuff that works, man. For real, for real. You can go ahead with your next question.
All right. So that's another message, you guys. Back to the basics, okay? Mm-hmm. So, AJ, let me ask you another question because you be giving away a lot of sauce on the channel. Yeah. Yeah. But what has been your secret to growing real fast? Because you shot up real quick.
I think it was mainly just systems. Like once I realized that was the key, just whatever you're trying to do, hire somebody else to do it. Mm-hmm. Like figure out how to do it, put somebody in it, trust them, bye. Like handle it. If you can't handle it, get somebody else to do it. You know what I mean? Like you got to really be like, I give my people freedom, but I'm also strict. Like they know, all right, this is what I told you to do, why you ain't do it. You know what I mean? Right. And I'm on that. And so but typically, I mean, I don't know. I guess it's just mainly putting things in place. I'll be scared to say certain things because I'm scared to scare people.
Right,
I'm
going
to go ahead and talk.
But, I mean,
it's
the real clean conversation.
All right, let's do it. I'm going to tell you another thing I do, too. So the faster you grow, the more it's going to cost, too. So my bills expand very quickly on the business side.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm.
So it's like, well, damn, I guess I better sell some more then because I damn sure ain't, you know, I told you I ain't going back to get no job. So you're going to have to sell some more. And it's mainly that. It's just like, I listen to a lot of Grant Cardone and he does that where it's like, he basically says, stay broke. Mm-hmm. I mean, because you know, you don't be, I'm telling you, when my nice and comfortable, money is up, everything is good, I start sleeping in. You know what I mean?
That's all you be like me.
See?
This is so creepy, you guys. Like, it's like listening to him, it's like listening to her. Yeah. It's like crazy. You guys are the same person.
You know, literally, though, when I seen her trying to come up, and then when I heard her rap, I said, no, hell no.
Oh, yeah. Oh, that was another thing. That was like, this nigga rap, too.
Right.
Oh, Lord.
Look, you got me trying to memorize the lyrics to the intro and stuff. I'm like, yeah. Right. Then I actually seen you post the actual whole song.
Yeah.
I'll see myself in the mirror like, I'm trying to remember the whole song.
You gonna have to go back and do that.
I'm gonna have to redo that.
Yes.
You know what? The whole thing over.
Cause my cousin Poser did that second verse. You can do the second verse. That's what we should do.
Look.
That's what we should do. Look.
Alright, y'all heard it.
I love
that's
it. You heard it first, y'all. Yeah. Oh my God.
To the top.
I'm sorry, that just stopping me. Threw me off, okay, y'all? Right. That's good news. So what's another one, AJ? Okay. Employees versus contractors.
Yeah, that's a good one.
I hate answering that one only because I like contractors. And I know that I understand the complications that can come with if you misclassify a 1099 contractor as an employee and all the fines you're going to owe. So that's why I hate like saying it. But for me, I like it better because my management style. I'm not going to micromanage you at all. I'm going to hire you. You're going to do what I told you to do or asked you to do or that we agreed on how we got to word it. But you're going to do what you, know what I mean, what we said you was going to do. And then I'm going to trust you 1,000%. I ain't really like, I mean, I might pop in here and there, but for the most part, I need people that's independent. Mm-hmm. And most of the time, not every time, most of the time, W-2 employees just simply aren't driven like that. They there for the check and that's it. But when you get the 1099 contractors that take pride in their work, they've been doing this for 20 years. And, mm-hmm. Oh, I know how to clean. You know, they put a little pride into it. All they just need is a little guidance, most of them. They don't know how to get their own customers most of the time. Mm. So you like the link between them getting the customers. You know what I mean? And then it's like they're going to take care of the cleaning part for you. And like that's the way I like to do it is partnerships. Because I know I'm not a good employee most of the time. I hate when somebody telling me what to do and don't give me my freedom. So I just try to create the opportunity for somebody that I wished I had when I needed a job.
Oh, I love that. Yeah. So, you know, both of you guys have a image, you know what I'm saying? Because people have grown to love you guys. So sometimes you might come across people just wanting to work for you because of who you are. And they might even not even know what to do. So how do you deal with that? Like people just wanting to work for you because of who you are, but they don't know what to do. Like for real.
Train them. train them. So that I always use that to my advantage. Mm-hmm. That the fact that, because see, a lot of times when people already knew who I was coming in, that gave me leverage. They didn't want to let me down. Mm-hmm. It's like that's how I got good. Because when I first cleaned, remember I told you I got my first cleaning company at 19, and I was a trash cleaner. Mm-hmm. But I got better at cleaning after I sold the Coverall franchise, and I started doing like what do you call it? Like basically like subcontracted for random cleaning companies, right? Mm. They were small guys, so I could work hand in hand with them. Mm. And when I would clean for them, I would put my all in because I felt like I'm an owner just like he an owner, so I can't mess it up. Right. And then they would come in and tell me about complaints while I'm messing. I'm like, how the hell? I know for a fact I cleaned it right. But then they were like, no, you see them cobwebs up there? Or no, these behind the monitor, all that dust back there? And it was stuff I never thought to think, to look at. You know what I mean? So, damn, I forgot how I got to that. I stay doing that. Where was I going with that? Damn.
It's all right. Just like writer's block, man. It's all right, man.
It happened every time.
I was just asking because
I like contractors as well.
Yeah, contractors are good.
You know what I mean? Yeah. Like but when I say this humbly, it's nothing wrong with employees.
Disclaimer.
There are so many million-dollar companies, and I feel like people like Miss Angela, the lady that just left, she got nothing but employees. And when you come from, she's been in business for 20 years, too.
Yeah.
Okay, so she comes from a different era. And it's not only that. It has something to do with your company structure and who you are as a person.
Yeah.
I feel like it has a lot to do with it. Mm-hmm. Me, I ain't got a lot of patience for babysitting. I got 5 kids.
Okay.
So I don't have a lot of patience for micromanaging every little thing. I feel like with employees, you got to micromanage every little thing. So it's harder. It would be harder for me to build that way. It's easier for me to build with a contractor because you want to be a business owner. You want to be independent.
Mm-hmm. Right.
You don't want nobody looking over you and hovering over you and all that stuff. Now, granted, if you mess up, we hold you accountable by not paying you until you get it done. Mm-hmm. It's different when you have a contractor, someone that not just an independent contractor, but someone that actually wants to build a company.
Right.
You know, it's a difference between the contractors, right?
Absolutely.
It's a difference. You got your independent person that just solely works for themselves.
Yep.
You know, and then you have the person that wants to build a company. Mm-hmm. They want to go big. I want to be like you.
Right.
It's a different person.
Yeah.
You know, just like you say, it's a different type of individual that you, and they are a lot more easier to deal with because they want to be independent. We align together.
Yep.
You align with my lifestyle and what I can tolerate as a business owner. I can't tolerate too much of me just holding your head every little step of the way. Yeah. That would drive me crazy. Okay, so that's why I say contractor.
I love it. Yeah. Well, I got 2 questions for the both of y'all.
Okay.
Mm-hmm. All right, so first question is, how do y'all deal with, like, contractors, you know, that come? Because, you know, sometimes you get a little spiffy at the mouth.
Okay.
You know what I'm saying? How do y'all deal with that?
Let me take a drink.
Oh, look. How y'all deal with that?
AJ, you the guest.
So I don't know if... All right, I'll lead with this. I think the energy you give, a lot of times you're going to get that back, so that's the first thing. But the second thing is this. I don't deal with it at all.
Right.
You try that shit if you want to, you gone.
Right.
All
right.
That's how you feel. Bye. Go find somebody else to do it for.
Right.
I love you. Know it. What I mean? And then ain't nothing. So I don't deal with it. But then a lot of times too, I've always, I don't know if this make a difference either. Mm-hmm. don't nobody shoot me now. But
candy clean conversations.
Right. But I'm a male. I dealt with mostly males as 1099 contractors. And from my observation in my little 35 years of life, we don't tend to be confrontational too much. Mm. And so I ain't really had a lot of those problems. The one time I had a close to a problem like that guy, he was fresh out of prison. Mm-hmm. And I was trying to help my people fresh out of, I tried to. Mm-hmm. And then and he broke a camera. I saw him walk, like, because the customer replayed the video for us. Mm-hmm. And they was like, we just want you to see something. So mm-hmm. you can see him, he like mopping, but he keep looking back at the camera, Mm-hmm. Next thing you know, he put the mop down. He walks over. You can tell he walked under. Next thing you know, the camera go blank.
Wow.
And so they said they don't see nothing missing or anything, but we all assumed that he must have been setting up to steal later. So after that, I had no choice but to let him go. I know I ain't had no proof that you stole. I'm assuming that you were trying to steal, but the bottom line is either way you damaged their property, I got to pay for that.
Right.
You know what I mean? And so...
was he argumentative with you?
Yeah. That's what I'm about to get at. Mm. So when it came time for to go get the key back from him, it was like, all right, how about to handle it? So he was like, and I just let him talk, let him vent, you know what I mean? And so when he finally calmed down, cause my wife's sitting there, like I got him on speaker, she's sitting like, telling me fire, like,
that's me.
You know what I mean? I'm like, nah, chill, I got this. No, cause you gotta have patience too, you know what I mean? Like let people, cause I dealt with that all the time in the streets too. So it was like, as the ball, sometimes you gotta be more calculated. You know what I mean? You can't jump just because they jump on or shoot. Just cause, like, you gotta know how to move. So
chess, not checkers.
Know what I mean?
Yeah.
I had a teacher.
I let him get his little stuff off or whatever. But then it's like, all right, bro. So let me ask you this. That's okay. I'm gonna get you something else. Don't worry about it. I'm gonna get you something else. Mm-hmm. So tell a little white lie. Know what I mean?
My God, we do the same.
And my big heart, I kind of was considering, like, maybe if I get him in a less, I don't know, a different type of building, but I didn't do that. But anyway, so I got him to calm down. I convinced him to meet me somewhere, give him the key. Nah, man, we dot double it up. No, you good, bro. Just keep thinking positive, da da da, getting some positive words, and I pick up for him again. And I never saw him.
That's
again.
A jewel right there.
You know,
that's a message. That's a huge
and I wish
message.
You the best. I hope, you know what I mean? I hope you're doing well in life. But
yeah, we got to humble ourselves.
I mean,
especially from where we come from. You know, we come from getting snappy back with a person. But when you make a transition over to being a CEO, it ain't that situation.
Right.
You don't want that. You don't want negativity. I don't want nobody breaking into my dang office.
Right.
I don't need them type of
problems. Standing outside waiting for you.
Listen, yeah, exactly. I'll give you one of my worst contracts before I do that. You know, it's been situations where I might be about to let a contract go.
Yeah.
And if I want to let an IC go, y'all might be the perfect match to each
other. Right.
Y'all might be the perfect match for each other. Because they ain't paying me on time.
They ain't want you. But they ain't want you no more. I'll let you know.
And you screwing up. I'm like, listen here. I transition out of one contract, and then I introduce you to the person I don't really want no more. Y'all marry each other, and I'm sliding on the way. Are y'all happy? Everybody happy? It's easy.
Wow.
It's easy. It be like that sometimes.
I love it. You guys. Know?
But really, we do that to save our energy. Mm-hmm. You know, I always talk about frequencies and how you got to keep our frequencies high.
Mm-hmm.
We can't, you know, when a person call you, rah, 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 that frustrates you. And it can mess up your whole mood.
Yep. For the whole day.
I'm feeling good today. I'm about to interview AJ, and you just call me fussing. And that's why all the phones are off.
Right? Mm-hmm.
I don't want to hear it. I had my conversation, my meeting this morning with my VA and my son. He's over my account in Statesboro now. The college that we got in Statesboro. I said, listen, we got some new people starting today. I don't want no phone calls.
Yeah.
You handle that account, son.
Yeah.
You handle that account. I don't want nobody calling me. I don't want no complaints. I don't want to hear, I don't know how to find the building. I don't want to hear, I don't know about the code, how to get in. Yep. You find, as if I get a phone call, my phone's going to be off at 11 o'clock.
Right.
Because we're going to be recording.
Right.
Okay.
Right.
So I really need to save my energy, because the littlest thing will fly me over. Man, I'll be mad.
Right.
Now I'm mad all day.
Right.
Now I'm interviewing. You know, my energy is different because I'm upset. You know what I mean? So you got to watch your energy and your tempers and stuff, y'all.
I don't think I could have said it better myself.
Right.
But my second question for you guys is, just being a business owner, how are y'all able to balance family and business?
Oh, God.
I answered look, I answered this a couple of times, and I say it like this. It's very easy to do to me when you accept that balance don't mean 50-50.
Right.
You know, I mean, a lot of times people hear that and think, is everybody gonna get the same time? No. For these couple of months, the business might get the most time. For these couple of months, the family might get the most time. But I mean, it's just more so it depends on the season that we in. If we in grind mode, we in grind mode. And I think once you, as an entrepreneur, if you got a family with it, they'll understand after a while, oh, daddy at work. You know what I mean? Or Jenna, no, all right, let me get out of his way. You know what I mean? Mm-hmm. So it's just like, you just go through those seasons, and then we grind for freedom anyway. It ain't really about the money, about the freedom first. So I get, like, when I'm off grind season, shit, I you know what I mean? Like, right now, one of them modes where I'm working, 3 days a week probably. Mm-hmm. So it's like, we cool. You know what I mean? We got family time, but whenever I need to turn up, they already know, leave daddy alone. So
yeah, I like that. What about you, Ms. Johnson?
It ain't no balance. Right now, I'm in the season of grind. I'm still in my grind mode season. Yeah. For whatever reasons, I have to be on grind mode until I meet my milestone that I feel like I should have already met yet. So this year, I look at it as my Jordan season, 23. So it's like, I give like 80%, I would say, to my business right now. That's how it is. And it sucks, but sometimes I had to bring the kids to the office. You know, you be in here with me. They be running around, getting on my nerves and stuff. But that's my way of spending mommy time while I'm trying to do what I need to do. Sad to say. Yeah. But, you know, at least they with me and they ain't with grandma. Yeah. You know, and then it's been times when we will take the kids to the park or we will take the kids out to eat, but I still got my laptop.
Right.
You know what I mean? I still got my laptop sometimes because I'm in grind mode.
Right.
You know,
yeah.
I don't recommend all the mothers to do it that way, but I'm just being transparent. That really is, that's my world right now because of the season that I'm in. I feel like I got to go hard now so that I can be able to spend my fit forever with them and be able to give them all of my time.
Right.
You know what
right.
I mean? But right now, I ain't in that season of all, you know, it's probably about 20% where it's just no interruption, just me and my kids. Yeah. You know,
I love
that. When we went out of town and all the phones was off, boom. But it's only about 20% of that going on right now.
Right. I like that. But how do y'all transfer that message to the kids? You know, maybe family, friends, wife, spouse. Like, how do y'all, like, get that to them to understand, hey, listen, it's nothing personal. It's just I got to, you know, do the business thing. You know what I'm saying?
I think it's sales. I mean, sales, everything is sales. So you got to sell them on the dream. Like, listen, remember when we went to so-and-so and so? That's because I was grinding like this.
Right.
Look around. You see this house we in? That's definitely one of my go-tos. It's because I was, remember, I'm in that season again. We got to grind. So it's just like, not to throw it in their face, you know what I mean? But it's just a reminder. Like, listen, look at the life that we want to have. Mm-hmm. We want to get up and go whenever we feel like going. So it's like, well, these are the repercussions and the sacrifices that's required in order to live that particular lifestyle. So you just kind of remind them what the goals is. And we do vision boards, and we ride through neighborhoods that's nicer than the one we in now. You know what I mean? And just always keep, all that. So try to manifest and just remind them of the goals.
Right.
I love
it. It's a good thing you said vision board, because the next question was, what does the future hold
for CBN?
For CBN. What can we be expecting from CBN in the future?
That right there is going to be a question that when I answer, it's going to always probably be wrong.
Oh, man.
It's
going to
change.
It changes every day, man.
Change.
I mean, before it was, I want to have the biggest cleaning company. Like, I wanted to switch, but I was going to, like, all the different Clean Biz Network members.
Right.
You run that branch, we run that branch, you run that branch, and we just be all over the world taking over.
Right.
But then it turned into, actually, I want the biggest software company ever. You know what I mean? Then it's like, well, actually, I'm trying to get this about 10-something million. And since it's a SaaS company, I can sell it for 100 and go chill somewhere. Like, I really don't know I honestly don't. But that dream of having that biggest cleaning company, though, that one hit the hardest for some reason to me. Just because it's more tangible. And I feel like I can touch more lives in that way. But I honestly don't know.
Right. With a cleaning business growing that big, I don't think that's probably not my dream. Sometimes I'll be wanting to just kick the cleaning business to the side. Right. Cause it's just, it gets, a little frustrating sometimes, you know, when you're in that growth season, and you can tell your company will tell you when your systems ain't right.
Yeah.
It's something wrong.
Yeah.
You know, and your company will let you know definitely when you're growing fast, you got to deal with taxes. You got to deal with, you know, having the right, everything falls back to systems, man.
Everything.
And having a team.
Yeah.
A perfect team to look at. I need a whole finance team to help me with all this.
Yeah.
Because, you know, the time is flying by so fast in the day. And I don't have time to look at every number. I don't have time to, you know, analyze everything that's going on in the company, man.
Yeah.
So with digital, however, I've learned that when you go digital with building a YouTube channel, you don't have no overhead with YouTube.
Oh, yeah.
Like, YouTube pays you on the 21st of each month.
Mm-hmm.
I said, I like that. I mean, if I'm really going to think about the future of me, I'm going to go with what I can do the best with ease.
Mm-hmm.
You know, what's easy for me as a mom, 5 kids, fiance, what is easy for me?
Yeah.
And going digital, that's easy.
It is.
You can coach people online. You know, you can do a course. You can sell a course. I ain't got to be there to sell the course.
Right, right.
You know what I mean?
Let's be clear. That's the reason right now I don't have the biggest cleaning company. Yeah, because it's very comfortable just doing it the way I'm doing it. Honestly, as a software company, as a coaching company, as a not having to be out here in the trenches company. And honestly, I'd be wanting to pivot my whole coaching narrative, basically, on my channel. It's like, you know what? All right. Cleaning was the way that I came up and got out of the job. Now, let me show you how I built $1 million net worth. You know what I mean? But it's like, well, I don't want to scare away the people who ain't, because everybody ain't technical, tech savvy either. And then I understand, like, I'm really, initially the motive was to help the people that came from where I came from.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I mean? Because I wish I had somebody like that. So it's like, and I'm like, damn, I'm one of those lucky ones that did grow up with a computer in the house. We weren't allowed to use it, but I was the only hard-headed one that jumped on and learned how to do it.
Right.
You know what I mean? Right. And so, but most people ain't tech savvy like that. So I'd be scared to like pivot in that way. But I definitely strongly consider that sometimes because it's the easier business, honestly.
You already doing it, baby. Yeah. You got the CRM that just came out.
The bidding calculator.
Yeah.
You got the bidding calculator.
Well, I mean, like teaching other people to do those things, though, versus teaching them the cleaning business. Because again, the cleaning business did get me out of my the poverty, so to speak, and out of the job. But the digital stuff
are
is definitely
different.
Are you afraid
of teaching people like all the sauce and giving them everything that you know?
Yeah.
What piece of information is safe that you keep sacred? You know what I mean?
There is, or absolutely. Every company has to do that.
Right, right.
But
right.
So what ends up happening is as I keep leveling up, I can let that go now.
Okay.
So I always learn new things when I drop them. But I can tell y'all this, the secret stuff that I do know, it's in my advanced course. So it's in cleaning business automation and it's in Get Paid to Be You, honestly.
Okay. That's like it. Y'all hear that? Clean Biz Automation
and
course.
Get Paid to Be You.
And Get Paid to Be You. Mm-hmm. All right. That's where all the secret sauce is at, you guys. But like, my question is, I'm happy that you're so humble and you're so giving.
Mm-hmm. Man.
And it doesn't scare you.
Mm-hmm.
For sure. And ain't gonna lie, I'm trying to think like right now, like what secret do I have? Like my old secret.
Oh, you ain't gotta tell your secret.
No, I don't mind. Let's go ahead and do it.
Look, I'm trying to hold the secret sauce up to make you go and invest into AJ. Okay.
No, where I'm trying to go at is the fact that you're not afraid to give.
Yeah.
You know, and the reason why you're not afraid to give, that's why you're receiving as much as you're receiving. Because it's not so much about the money.
Right.
And that's really the reason I'm touching on this is because you're the reason why I operate like that now.
Yeah.
Like, I just really be just, when people call me, I be giving them all the sauce.
Yeah.
Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? And they don't even realize it because it's free sometimes on a conference.
Yep.
They don't value it.
Right,
right. Right.
And we know that.
Yeah.
We know they're not going to value the information. And therefore, we're not scared to give. But when God says, you just be fruitful.
Yeah.
That's how I feel. Like, you know, I got it from him. He was just so giving. Yeah. You know, back in the day when I didn't know what the hell I was doing, I would hit AJ up. AJ would give me some advice, you know.
Yeah.
And I was just always amazed on how, you know, he was just so giving. Mm-hmm. I come from a world where everybody is you know, they don't want to give you so much because they feel like you're gonna come up and over and over and all that. You know what I'm saying?
Yeah, and I ain't gonna lie too. With far as the information go, another reason why I'm very freely with giving it is because it's, the information really ain't the play. People think the information is the key.
There you go.
You
hitting it.
The information really is like. Well, excuse me. For me. My secret stuff ain't the information. I kind of I tell you on YouTube what I'm doing,
right?
But it's how I'm doing it. It's copy this piece of code right here, or use this particular software to plug into that, and now it'll automatically do this for you. It's, my stuff is more like that, and it's stuff that I kind of jimmy-rigged together myself and figured out, so I know for a fact that this ain't no stuff you can just go Google,
right?
You know
what
I mean?
And I'm saying the mass majority, we already know.
They ain't gonna apply it anyway.
And that's the other thing.
It's like everybody knows how to lose weight. I always like to lose the weight.
That's facts.
You know,
you're
right. Fat as hell. You know you ain't supposed to be eating them cookies. You know you ain't supposed to be eating the chicken, the fried chicken, and all that stuff. You know you're supposed to eat better. You know you're supposed to work out. You know you're supposed to stay consistent. You know you're supposed to drink water.
Right.
Yeah.
It'd be the easy basic stuff.
Right.
But people don't do it. So it's something else. It's the discipline.
Yep.
It's the consistency.
Yep.
You know, it's something else that has to be wired within you that makes you really lock in, focus, be serious, and get the information done. Okay, so that's why I don't even think about it no more when I'm giving people. You know what I mean?
Yeah.
Like I don't even think about it no more because I know, you know, I have family, friends come up to me, man, help me.
Right. Here you go.
If y'all think it's that easy,
right.
Okay,
I'll be sitting here.
Have at it.
Right.
Shoot. You know, you know that only 1% is really going to go through that whole that whole thing, everything that you gave them.
Yeah.
And you literally be giving people the blueprint.
Yeah.
So I want to commend you on that. I don't know what you got in that other automation thing, but we got to get that and we got to figure out what it is. And
I mean,
y'all
man.
Very, very close too, by the way. As far as what you're doing with the alliances, you're very, very close.
Okay. Hello. Message.
That's just by following AJ.
Hey, man. So another message, you guys, like, I definitely want to give both of y'all flowers while y'all here. You know what I'm saying? It's definitely inspirational. Like, it's like, Ms. Johnson had a Bible. What would AJ do? You know what I'm saying? It was always, what would he do? You know, in this instance, you know what? We kind of think alike. Yeah. We are alike. But I must say, man, like for what you both have done, it has inspired me. You know what I mean? Yeah. To just stir up a lot of stuff in me to change my life and to be like, you know what? I can do this. And a lot of people don't give away free information like y'all do. But y'all, like I said, y'all are very transparent in what y'all say.
Yeah.
And that means a lot. So enough of that mushy gushy stuff. What we about to do is we about to get into our what
seat.
We call our hot seat. Okay, so we're gonna call this bottoms up. Okay, so you guys, with our bottoms up, we got like a few. He gonna have to choose between two. Okay, if he can't choose, he gonna have to take a drink. All right, see y'all ready?
Got water. You got the crown.
Yeah. Well, it's right here. You gonna have to pour his drink for him right here.
He know probably what I'm saying? Ain't even gonna have to take his crown because guess what? Easy stuff down there. I already know what he gonna say.
I'm probably gonna drink just for fun, honestly. All
right, so this first one, you guys, I'm about to see if he gonna drink. Well, I kind of already know this answer because he kind of let it up. And
you gotta tell him the rules of the game.
I already told him. If he can't answer, if he can't decide, he gonna take a drink.
It's either you gotta pick an answer or you gotta take a drink.
Okay. Nope. I watch Drink Champ, so I'm ready.
Look. All right. So you guys, like, we've been talking through the whole interview. You know what I'm saying? And I've been asking him these questions. Ms. Johnson been asking questions, and he actually been dropping the answer. So if you've been paying attention, then you already know how you gonna answer. All right. So AJ, brown versus white.
Brown. Yeah.
All right. Mm-hmm. Employees.
Both. Cause when I'm partying, I'm gonna go with the whites of both.
Oh, drink. All right. Employees versus contractors.
He already said contractors.
Contractors.
I'm trying to see if the people paying attention. Okay. You know what I'm saying? All right, so.
I didn't want to say both so bad. I want to drink.
All right, so let's see. Biggie versus Rick Ross.
Oh, that shouldn't be hard. And everybody gonna be mad at me for that being hard for me. Because I really, like, Ross is somebody I play daily.
I told you.
But out of respect, I gotta go Biggie.
Oh. All right, so let me see. Let me see. Jam Pro versus CBN Network.
Oh, Clean This Network. What are we doing? What are we talking about?
Come all right, all right, all right. Come on. All right, let's see. Tony Robinson or Grant Cardone?
I don't even know the first guy.
You don't?
Oh, no. See, he don't even know Tony Robinson.
All right, we're going to scratch that one then, you guys.
Oh, well,
Social Proof versus EYL.
There we go.
Oh.
I know that was
okay. All the things that I'm biting my tongue about in my head.
Cricket.
You know what I'm going to do?
Which one you watch the most?
I actually don't watch either.
Okay.
I did used to watch both at a particular time, though.
Okay.
But I'm going to go with both because salute to them for the work that they both put in.
There you go.
Drink. All right. Okay. So let me see. Who you think can spit most, Busta Rhymes or Eminem?
The best lyrics.
Look.
I'm going to go Busta, and I'm going to say because he is very underrated. He don't get the credit he deserves. Like, M get his credit.
He
so I'm automatically just give it to Busta because of that. But same time, though, people starting to disrespect M on that, too.
They is. Mm-hmm. They is.
I don't know,
bro. What about Eminem and Lil Wayne? Lyrically.
I drink.
Oh!
That's what I told you to ask the first time.
All right, so Nas versus Jay-Z.
That's another one. I'm going Nas.
Okay.
Wow.
I'm going
Are you going Nas? Okay.
You want the real answer?
Yeah.
Because I'm biased to the underdog. That's a real answer.
Yeah.
Honestly, it's probably a tie.
That's true.
Okay.
That's true.
Maybe Jay might. I don't know.
But people be saying that Jay-Z be spitting, which he do. He got his little bars, but I feel like for the new millennium, for us, like, I don't know. Like, I can't really. I could listen to somebody and I'd be like, damn, they spit. I listen to Megan all day and be like, she is.
No, she be killing it.
But, you know, with Jay-Z, I have to rewind it back. Right. Let me listen to this shit again.
That's how it should always been. Yeah.
Yeah, let me guess it.
For him to be, for him to be like.
If you want a billionaire and he won't marry to Beyonce, we probably wouldn't be mentioning him like that. If we were just talking rap only, if I'm honest. They gonna hang me for that too, though.
Oh well,
they gonna hang me too, honey, because I don't know, man.
Whatever. And if they want to try to hang you, that's their business. Anybody got time for that? All right. So, Go High Level or Active Campaign?
I gotta go High Level because we just integrated that with Clean Biz Network software, and I never use Active Campaign, so I gotta go High Level.
Okay.
Well, you guys, I just want to know one thing. What's something that no one knows about AJ? You got to dig in that box for that.
Yeah, I'm gonna
don't give me no generic bullshit.
Honestly, as transparent as I am, y'all know all my secrets already.
Mm-hmm.
Like, I talk about how I drink more than I probably should. I talk about, I don't know. I talk about I'm scared of dogs. Everybody know that. I done said that on YouTube. Damn.
I know there's something because you don't talk about everything on camera now.
Well, think of a question that you think that I wouldn't think of something you think I haven't said.
Let me think. All right, so let me think about something that a lot of people might want to know.
I already know he an introvert. He really do just putting it all out there. All
right, so you be rapping and stuff,
okay,
right?
Okay.
Can you think of something off
what
the
what was dome? Your rap name? That's a good one.
Oh yeah, because I was trying to figure out that was actually going to be a question. Yeah. I was going to say AJ versus your rap name, but I ain't know your rap
name. Oh dang, so my rap name was Anthony Kane.
Okay.
And how'd that come about?
I wanted to give you the story. So it came about, so I did a little short stint in the military, and I was in Army National Guard. So when I was going to the basic training part, a guy from Chicago, he was like an ex-game member or whatever, so me and him was real close because we come from the streets. So.
Mm-hmm.
And then he told me, I'm embarrassed to say this part. He told me that he kept calling me Kane. Mm-hmm. And I'm like, bro, why you keep calling me? Like, actually, I ain't say bro, because we ain't say bro back then. I probably said nigga or something like that. Mm-hmm. But anyway, so he was like, yeah, I call you Kane because of the movie. What is it?
Mortal Kombat?
Menace of Society.
Menace of Society.
Oh, okay.
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
And I'm like, dang. So I haven't seen that movie since I was like a baby back then. I didn't really know. So I was like, you don't know? I said, man. He was like, you got to watch it. So that was the part I was embarrassed to say that I ain't, I won't hip to it at the time. But anyway.
It's all right.
So I watched it. I was like, oh, yeah, I could see me being like that. Okay, bam, I'm going to keep that Kane part. But I was like, but if I'm going to do it, it got to be a part of my name. Because I always hated when people had them crazy rap names, Flizzle, Tizzle, and all of that shit. So I got to have some part of me up in there. And I mean, for it to be real. So I put the Anthony in front of her, and that's how I came with Anthony Kane. But another funny story. So I had a name before that, and I was a teenager. And it was PBK, which stood for...
PBK.
Embarrassing to say now.
I want to know.
It stood for Pretty Boy Killer. And so... and I got it. I don't have no tattoos, but I got like a burnt one. And it say PBK over there.
Where is he?
You probably can't see him too dark. And then it went away after so many years. Let me see. Yeah, you probably can't see it. But it's there, though.
Hey, so, I'm PBK.
There you go, y'all. Don't
that's something nobody knows,
now.
Actually.
That's something nobody knows, y'all. Yeah. It ain't online. You ain't put it online or nothing.
Okay, so you guys heard it first, okay?
That's exclusive. Oh, all right, man. Well, I thank you for driving all the way to Savannah, Georgia.
Yes.
To be with us today. And for that, I'm gonna be driving all the way to Jacksonville,
can't
Florida.
Wait. Yeah.
Okay. Mm-hmm. And I want to thank you again for letting me be able to speak, you know, on your stage.
Yes.
Okay. And I told Miss Tamika, you know, I said, I'm scared. I don't know.
I never would have guessed that.
But she was like, girl, please, you can tell them yes, we're gonna do it. So I said, oh shit. Whew. But I always been telling her that I wanted to speak, you know what I mean? And then when you asked, I was like, well, there go God again, just pushing me out there to do what I always keep saying I wanted to do, you know? And with practice, you'll get better and all that good stuff. But, you know, you got to jump out there and do what you do. And I just wanted to thank you for that as well. I want to close it out with talking about the Clean Biz Network Conference.
Okay.
We touched on it lightly.
Yeah.
So I want to get into who's going to be there. What is it all about?
Yeah.
What can people expect when they come out?
Expect a great time. Like, honestly, like,
last year was a good time.
I'm telling you. Like, we
drank too much. I had to go.
You didn't even see us.
You didn't even see me at the end of the night. I was already in the room.
Yeah, I remember because you came back down to the bar. We was out there at the bar for like, and so we were like, tell her come down. And I was like, oh, okay, so that's the reason. All right.
Oh, I was out.
Okay, but yeah, expect a celebration of the cleaning industry. Expect a lot of education. Like last year, I learned a lot shout out to Ricky.
Big shout out to Ricky. Yeah,
shout out.
I learned a lot from him, and I think this year it's just gonna be Jason instead of Ricky this time. Mm-hmm. But we always bring at least one like big dog
big
to.
Dog.
Know what I mean? And like that we all can just glean from too. In addition to all of us, you know what I mean? Mm-hmm. And so, but I learned a lot myself last year. So expect to learn a lot. Expect the party. We gonna actually have a party this year too.
Shoot.
Like, all right. So let me go down the list. So first night. On the 29th, Jason Lee will be speaking. He's the keynote. And big dog in the industry. If you haven't heard him, look him up on my YouTube channel. I got an interview with him. Mm-hmm. And then we're going to do just pretty much mix and mingle. So that first night, you really want to be there because that's the night when we're going to just be chilling. Like, we're going to first get the keynote speak, and then we're going to be just walking around. Everybody's talking. So if you ever want to just pull up on me and be like, AJ, for real. How you do this? You know what I mean?
Right.
That's your chance. Mm-hmm. You know what I mean? Especially with the drinks flowing. So,
There you go.
That's the chance. So then the next day, we're going to get up and ain't going to do too early because I already know we're going to be having a good time the night before.
Mm-hmm.
So 10 o'clock, Miss Debbie Sardone is opening up.
Awesome.
A monster.
She is a monster. She is a beast.
Like,
okay.
She is a beast. If you ever heard her speak, I'm telling you. Like, And you know what's unique about her too? And I hope she can cover this. Maybe I'll see if she can. Yeah, she has a nonprofit cleaning company.
Cleaning for a reason.
Yeah.
We're a member.
Yeah.
See, okay, bet. So y'all know all about this.
Yeah.
And it's like, damn. like that's a different perspective. So yeah. I would love if she could kind of touch on that. Maybe she won't because that might be herself. I don't know. You know, but
well, I definitely think she should.
That'd be great. Yeah, right, and I think she usually does her speech on systems, what she kills. Mm-hmm. But if she, yeah, I'll see if she'd be open to speaking on the nonprofit side of things too for a cleaning company. After that, we got an OSHA rep coming on. And so, you know, we're going to need the meat and potatoes of the things. Make sure we still following the rules.
That's right.
After that, I cannot believe, remember the order, but I'm going to try to guess it. I think it's my cousin. I'm coming after that. So I'm coming after that just to make sure everybody's still, you know what I mean, with us.
Okay.
So
okay.
I'm coming after that. I don't want to forget nobody. Probably Tony Williams.
Okay. Mm-hmm.
Going to do his thing. Clean Biz Network veteran. He killing it. I think last time I checked, he was about 30, 40 a month in revenue. So he's doing real good.
Pretty good.
Who else we got after that? Dan Amari's coming. That's my cousin. He's an attorney. He also owns a cleaning company. And I think we all might be having some legal questions. So that'll be your time to just be like, hey, about this. I ain't really sure about this. Can you help me with that? So he come in on that part. I believe it's Sean Richards next. Oh. Nope. Before Sean Richards, my guy Mario Kelly from Detroit. Killing it. He got the stadiums up there, like the actual, all the pro teams up there. He trying to get me to get the Jacksonville Jaguar Stadium with him, but I just be lazy and don't be feeling like doing nothing.
Oh,
but I'm going to do it with him, though. I'm
going to
work
with him. You need to do that with him.
Yeah, most definitely.
Yes, man.
So, he gonna definitely, I know he gonna kill it. He's gonna be, I think he's the only one that I'm doing interview style with this year. Cause he ain't never spoke before either. So it's like,
really?
I'm gonna just ask him the right questions. And then of course we're gonna let the crowd ask questions as well.
Mm-hmm.
And then he gonna come out there and
that's
kill
it. That's the guy that was on EYL, right?
Yes, he was on Earn Your Leisure.
He was on Earn Your Leisure. That's what we saw him at. I was
and
like,
listen to everything.
I had to hop on that quick. I said, let me reach out to him. Because
he talking about cleaning.
Right.
That should be you.
Right.
That's supposed to be you.
Salute to those brothers.
Salute to those brothers. Salute.
And so I saw my Earn Your Leisure and I said, let me get him over here because the title of that video was called I'll Start a Cleaning Business. And I didn't really hear how to start a cleaning business on that video.
So I said,
let me bring him over here and see if I can ask the questions that us cleaning industry people
would wanting to know.
You know what I mean? Yeah. So he gonna talk about that, how to get them big stadium contracts. Then my boy Sean Rich is coming, Clean Biz Network veteran, killing it.
Medical field too.
And everybody want that.
They got a lot of questions about that.
Yep.
Yes.
And he is, I think he just hit his million. So
really?
Yeah, if I'm not mistaken, he just hit his million. So
because shout out big with the medical facility, man.
Mm-hmm. Yeah, you know, he added that restaurant in too because when COVID hit last year, it kind of like rattled them a little bit. And not because they closed and didn't pay. Medical was good as far as the money. The problem was those vaccines.
Mm-hmm.
And, you know, everybody won't try to take them. So some of his workers didn't want them.
Mm-hmm.
And it's like, he don't know if he want to make them get it. You know what I mean? Like
employees.
That.
Man.
Right. Yeah. And so that was an issue. So I told him, I said, look, you're going to have to diversify. Like, get different type of contract just in case. So we don't know how this going to go. So he added on some restaurants and more things as well on top of the medical. So he going to kill it.
Wow.
And then after him, I had to make sure that I put you at the end because I was like, all right, I already know.
I'm going to be just all around, just telling them how I was able to, you know, grow my cleaning company and grow what we have grossed throughout these years and really just telling our story, man, being authentic with my, you know what I mean? That's all I know how to do.
Right.
But, man, I highly, highly recommend that you guys get this ticket.
Yeah.
Okay, we ain't really trying to like force sell no tickets on nobody, but we just really want to tell people how important it is to be in the right environment.
Yes.
Right.
You know, and be around people, like I said, that are doing way better, that are in revenue. And these stories that you're telling me is giving me chills. I'm like,
I'm
really
saying like,
what?
Am I here right now?
I remember when Sean first got started.
Yeah.
Okay.
He was still Ubering on the side. He was getting, he was sleeping, I think, because he had like three different states he was covering.
Mm-hmm.
And he was sleeping in the other state in his car, wake up Ubering and go do it again.
Sean was on the grind.
Yeah.
I remember. And it's like, I don't know what it was about 2018.
Yeah.
But it birthed a lot of entrepreneurs, you know. And then when COVID hit, it just went phew, like everybody just wanted to start a cleaning business at that point.
Mm-hmm.
So it really birthed a whole lot. you know. So I'm like, I'm excited. I want to be a part. I want to be in the building. I want to be around people. I want to shake hands, take pictures, and this is going to be a memorable moment.
Yeah, I'm ready for it because I'm hungry, you guys. Like, I ain't never been a cleaning business owner, but it's just being in the room. It's like being amongst legends. Like, that's how I feel. Every one of y'all are legends, and I feel like y'all are making a trademark on history. Like, and that's mad respect. And y'all better get y'all seats, okay?
I'm big ups to you for even starting of it,
man.
Because it's something that our culture needed, though.
It needed.
It really is. Like, it was missing. Yeah. Like, ain't nobody. You did it. You was the first one to do it. You know what I'm saying? Mm-hmm. And just big ups because we needed that. Like, I've seen it done everywhere else, but I haven't seen it done with us. You know what I mean? So I was like, damn, you know what I mean? He's the first person that really, really said, listen, we're going to do this. We're going to bring everybody together, and we're going to have this event. And I know that it's new for a lot of the people that are, you know, the newbies. Mm. The event and conference thing may be new for us. Mm-hmm. You know, well, not us, but, you know, the newbies that are coming up. They don't understand paying high ticket and all that.
Right.
So, being that I'm saying that, are you going up on the tickets?
Thank you for
I should.
They're the same price?
They still the $199.
Okay, all right. They're still $199, you guys. Just let you know.
And we got virtual tickets, so they can get those as well.
Oh, okay. And he got virtual tickets.
How much are those virtual?
So $199 as well. And then with the virtual, you can like pick which days you want to watch. So you ain't got to get the whole thing for the $199. You can get the Friday night and then the VIP party. Or you can get just the whole meat and potatoes on the second day and then not the VIP in the Friday. So
people have been asking me, do you have to be a member of Clean Biz Network in order to join the event?
No, it's open to everybody.
But both days?
Only the VIP part is for Clean Biz Network members only.
Okay, so the first day is for anybody.
Anybody. Second day is for anybody. Okay. But there's a second part of the second day. So the second day starts at 10, ends at 3:30. So after you speak, I'm going to come on after you, and then we stop, and everybody come go home, put your tux and your gown on, because we're doing straight balls after the VIP party.
Oh, so that's the kick.
Yeah. That's the part that's not to everybody.
So everybody don't get it. Okay.
Okay, I get it. Okay.
Now I feel important.
Who's been asking me that question, and I've been like, let me ask AJ Jack.
Right, because we're going to do an award ceremony at that part. We're going to do a quick panel with me, Carolyn Arellano, Diana, Mila, Brandon Orr, and then Tony Williams.
Shout out to them girls, panel. Man. Yeah, they're killing it.
Man, Mila.
All of them, man. I've been on everybody's page. You know, I'd be like, damn, they killing it right now. Okay. Killing it right now. Everybody.
Carolyn, I gave her flowers the other day on Clubhouse, but she is the closest thing that I've seen to you since because of just how she's doing it. She know how to hustle on both sides.
Oh, yeah.
I'll tell you, you know how to take the cleaning hustle and use it in this internet side.
That's right.
And that was something I knew how to do. You know how to do it.
Right.
I see her doing it. I'm like, boy, y'all dangerous.
Yeah. Okay. I got to get her in the studio too, dangerous. Man. I ain't got to it yet, but you got to put that on my to-do
list. So we coming for you, Carolyn, okay?
Yeah,
we coming for you.
We had Mila on. Didn't we have Mila on?
Yes.
We had
a delight. Had Mila on. Oh my God, she is too funny.
I love her personality.
Person. Yeah,
her personality.
Her spirit.
Yeah.
So I can't wait to actually meet everybody in person. All my internet friends, everybody that I watch and I'm inspired by. I get inspired by these people, you know, and that's what really keeps me going. Yeah. You know what I mean? Just watching everybody else just killing it, and I'm like, man, I'm about to go kill it.
Right.
I know, right? So you got any last words that you want to say to the people? Any encouragement words?
Yeah. I mean, if you ain't started your cleaning company yet, do it. I guess I should talk to this one now.
Mm-hmm.
Okay. If you ain't started a cleaning company yet, do it. Or any company. It ain't got to be cleaning. But any type of company you're thinking about starting, just try it. Get out there. Go all in on it. You get one life. I mean, do it as much as you possibly can. Enjoy yourself. You know what I mean? Get out here and live. And other than that, that's all I got. Thank y'all ladies for having me on. It was a pleasure. I had fun. And y'all already know, y'all done gave me a drink too. I'm having a great time. Let me stop doing shit too.
We try.
Because I'm promoting alcohol and that's poison. Let me stop.
But anyway, you guys, I know y'all was trying to look at me like, ask him this, ask him that. No. I'm not asking him that.
Y'all can ask him at the conference.
Okay.
There you go.
Okay, y'all need to come out there at the conference and you can actually meet this man and ask him all the questions that you want to ask. Yeah. Mm-hmm. Hey, you can meet me too. Hey, listen, I was feeling like a celebrity at the last conference.
I'm telling you, look.
But people was coming up to me. I was like, me? Just right. Little old me? Okay. Well, cool. Let's sit down. Let's
yeah, talk. She acting like a little owl. Who?
She was like, somebody else want to talk to you. Somebody else want
to. Look,
like,
AJ, yeah. I got up from my seat for like 5 seconds. As soon as I got up, I had to go use the bathroom.
Yeah.
As soon as I got up.
I was flocked with people. Right. I was like, okay,
they cool. Couldn't wait to come in.
But that love is yeah. That's why we do it.
Yeah.
You know what I mean? Yeah. You do it for the love. You don't do it for the money.
You know you actually you making an impact mean? On these people for them. You know what I mean? To react the right. Way they reacting is like you know you really doing something.
Mm-hmm. It's that love that keep you going, yeah. Man. You be like, man, I'm really changing somebody's life like the way this man changed my life. Yeah. Like mm-hmm. I'm like.
I was literally there introducing myself like they weren't there for my event, but
right.
I just still felt well. Maybe they saw Katrina on the flyer, you know what I mean? Or maybe they saw somebody else. I know who you is. I'm right, like, my bad. Shit. I'm just trying
like,
to
people, I'm
be
telling
courteous.
You, I was walking down the hall and people was like, "Why you acting like you ain't you?
Yeah, yeah, yeah.
Like you ain't who you is. Like, all right, thank you. Like yeah. You know what I mean? Like it was a humbling. It was everything to me. Like it was really like dope. And that was the first time we actually met him in person mm-hmm. last year.
I was like, yeah. Wow, like man, what I definitely tell you, you got a lot of grace. Mm-hmm. A lot of grace. You mm-hmm. and Miss Johnson.
We talked all the time. You're like, you know.
Yeah, it didn't feel like internet, it was the first time meeting.
You know what I mean?
Mm-hmm.
Like,
the way we talked. Yeah.
We seen him, that's like our brother. I was like, damn, you know what I mean?
Yeah, we'd be looking at the comments like, I dare you say something.
Right.
You know? You
and
say
another thing, like people know now, you can't come to me and hate on Jay's. AJ, okay, mm-hmm. because I'm not gonna have anything to say to you to like entertain that.
Mm-hmm.
Okay, so you know if anybody got anything bad to say or whatever, they don't bring it my way.
Right. I tell them come see me.
we that's not what we doing. We ain't there. You know
appreciate
what I mean?
And so we same energy.
Yeah,
for sure.
You know it's all love. You mm-hmm. know you can't, and that's the power in like when you really empower somebody else. Mm-hmm. Like we do our contractors all the time. You know mm-hmm. When you're dealing with contractors, one thing I say, it's a dirty game,
mm-hmm.
and people will like backdoor you.
Yeah.
And I've had people backdoor me all the time.
Mm-hmm.
It's cool. I've learned how to take my emotions out of it and just mm-hmm. keep going and let them. If that client and you y'all decided to do that, y'all are good for each other, honey.
Yeah.
That wasn't my client right there. That's cool if y'all had let that happen or whatever. I'm going to keep on moving, and I'm going to keep the people that I got that are loyal to me.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? Those are the people that I want in my circle. I want people like Miss Tamika. I want people like you. I want people that are genuinely loyal to my company
mm-hmm.
in my circle.
Mm-hmm.
And I keep those people, and those people, I will forever be loyal back to them. Yeah. If they need something, man, we don't went to bat for people, man. Cars and got doggone.
Let's not go into all that.
We'll
be here all day.
I don't want to get into all that, but people mm-hmm. be ringing my phone up. But you know, it's just it's the genuine. You love somebody, they're gonna love you back genuinely, man. Like
it's I love both of y'all, man. Yeah. This is straight up family. Like I
it's
love
real
both
family
y'all.
With this one right here.
Mm-hmm.
It's family.
Straight up.
But thank you, man. Thank you for coming. I done rambled enough because I done drunk enough. And
yes.
It's time to wrap up this interview, y'all.
Okay.
This is another episode of
Candy Cleaning Conversations.
And we out here, y'all. Hey.
How you doing?